FM with Josh Sacom. He is doing something that usually puts fear into people's hearts, running against a longtime incumbent. But he's not afraid of Secretary of State William Galvin, and he's positioning himself as a progressive. Thanks for coming by. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
So, how's it going so far?
You know, I think we're in a really strong position. We've got 20 days to go until this primary on September 4th, the day after Labor Day, which I think is important to remind people of, that if you're still going to be traveling, please vote absentee, which you can do from now until the end of the month. We have a real opportunity for a progressive change in the Secretary of State's office for the first time in a generation. We need a Secretary of State in Massachusetts who's going to fight for things like same-day voter registration, weekend voting, making it easier to vote by mail, to participate in our democracy, things that Bill Galvin has just opposed over and over during his 24-year tenure.
Now, so far, I know that you've tried to get him to debate you. Mm-hmm. Have you gotten any sort of commitment from him to actually talk?
Actually, on about 14 hours' notice, we had a debate last night. He agreed just before, about 12, 14 hours before the debate began. So it was on GBH, the Greater Boston Show, and it was an interesting exchange. He seems very angry and offended that anyone would even attempt to challenge him for this seat, and I think it's a somewhat of a disturbing attitude for an elected official.
Now, your platform has a lot of stuff about trying to get people involved in voting. Yeah. You really want to make it very easy. Can you just run through a couple of those steps that you would undertake if you were elected?
Well, number one is same-day voter registration. 17 states have it. D.C. has it. It greatly addresses some of the inequities in our society. Folks who move more often, which are often younger people, lower-income folks, who maybe not have the 20 days ahead of time to register. We have one of the longer registration periods in the country. We need to be doing better on this. And Secretary Galvin has opposed this from his time in the legislature to now. We're winning a court case just last month to maintain our 20-day registration deadline. That's wrong for Massachusetts.
Is there any justification for that? I mean, why should we wait 20 days?
I think maybe 20 or 30 years ago, when technology was a little different, our lifestyles were different, it might have made sense, but certainly right now it doesn't.
Now, the Secretary of State's office has a lot of duties that people don't really understand. You've got a huge commitment to historic preservation.
Yeah.
What are your positions on that? Yeah.
Well, the Mass Historic Commission, which is under the Secretary's purview, is an incredibly important division there, and it's not well known. So as you mentioned, it has a role around historic preservation, protecting the treasures of our history here in Massachusetts. But another important function of the Mass Historic Commission is the awarding of historic tax credits, up to $50 million a year across the Commonwealth. And I believe that those scarce public dollars should be going to create more affordable and middle-income housing in high-cost areas, but also need to be distributed with more transparency and geographic equity to communities across Massachusetts that maybe aren't seeing the same economic boom the Greater Boston area has seen these last few years. We need to be working with local economic development officials, nonprofits, to really leverage those grants to benefit the greatest number of people instead of using them to subsidize the construction of more luxury hotels in downtown Boston.
Josh, thank you much for stopping by. Enjoy the picnic. This is the first time here?
It is. I'm excited. Thanks for having me.
My pleasure.